My name's Susan Nylon, and I'm your MC for this morning. I just saw Cooper Levy Baker come in early, so he'll be your MC for this afternoon. I am the owner of WSRQ Radio, and you can hear me every day on my station, 4 to 6 on the Nylon Report, and I'm happy to be here. This is my second year in returning, and I'm always thrilled because I have strong roots in the sustainable community here, and it's always thrilling that I see year after year this event do so well. I'm told to give you a couple of notes. There are bathrooms located in the main hall on the left side. There's also one upstairs that you can use in case the other one gets crowded. They do have recycling in this building. There are two blue bins over there. They ask you to please use them. And I'm also told that the first person to walk across the bridge out there to see the beautiful foliage will be kind enough to knock down all the spider webs that are there. We're just giving you a heads up. All right, this morning's agenda includes discussions on a number of topics that you'll find interesting and useful to you and your communities. We want to thank our sponsors for their generous support of today's workshop. Our silver level sponsors, Region Solar, Florida Department of Environmental Protection, Sarasota Bay Estuary Program, Southwest Florida Water Management District, Charlotte Harbor National Estuary Program, and our bronze level sponsors are the Sarasota County Green Business Partnership. What a great lineup of our supporting communities. If you're active in social media, please feel free to post throughout the day. The hashtag for the workshop is hashtag SCW14. And I'll remind you of that throughout the program because it's really good to get the message out there. Speakers are welcome to mention their Twitter handles in their talks. Please help the conversation going online to help spread the word. Speaking of the conversation going on, I hope you've completed your What I Want in My Sustainable Community sticker that you received when you checked in this morning. Ringling College of Art and Design's Tim Rummage is taking photos of the various stickers that we will share with all of you later in the day. Finally, please remember to silence your cell phones before we get started. Now it's my pleasure to introduce the chair of the Sarasota County Commission, who will be giving the opening remarks. Commissioner Charles Hines has served on the County Commission since 2012. He's an attorney in Venice and has been practicing law for 22 years in Sarasota County. His business experience includes directorship of the Venice Area Chamber of Commerce and as a previous co-owner of United Healthcare Services. His community and civic association activities include the Sertoma Club of Venice, United Way of South Sarasota, Big Brothers and Big Sisters, and the Venice Little League. He has also coached numerous youth football, baseball, and soccer teams. Commissioner Hines is currently serving on the Sarasota Bay and Charlotte Harbor National Estuary Committees and the National Association of the Sarasota County Green Business Partnership. Did I read off script? And I'm sorry. The Southwest Florida Regional Planning Council and the Water Planning Alliance Board. He is deeply connected to the Sarasota through both his service and his family and is a true advocate of a growing sustainable community for all. Please join me in welcoming Commissioner Charles Hines.
Good morning. Thanks, Susan.
You're welcome.
I was talking to Lee Byron this morning a little bit, and how many, are most folks here from Sarasota County or local, pretty much? Okay, good. How many have been to this event before? All right. I'm the fear of everyone is I may go a little off script here because of that. I feel like, you know, I'm speaking to our own community versus folks from outside. So I can use some examples that you may be familiar with, and we're doing this. But first of all, I'm going to give you some background on this event and this workshop and give you some history and then make a few comments and get some information from you all. So again, my pleasure as chairman of the County Commission to welcome you to this workshop. And this workshop's really been a true partnership among all of our local community leadership. So this event began as a grant from the U.S. Department of Energy in 2006. And has brought together incredible speakers at these workshops to inform and inspire our community on a variety of issues. The first workshop focused on sustainable transportation. Other workshop themes addressed home retrofits, water management strategies, and the green economy. So here's where I'm gonna get off script a little bit. So the first one dealt with sustainable transportation. And so I'll put us all on the spot here. How many people came here by public transportation this morning? Okay. How many people rode their bike here today? All right. We still got a lot to do. And so we recognize as a policy setter in the county commission, you know, our community is really in between. If you're New York City, public transportation's there. It's easy. You know, we have incredible density that it makes sense. If you live out in a farm in North Dakota and you got to drive 300 miles to work, running a bus system doesn't really make sense. We're in between. And so we're constantly, with the decisions that we make, are looking to ways that when our community, the next 10, 20, 30 years, where are we going to be and how's public transportation going to work? So I ask you that. I didn't see anybody raise their hand. So coming to an event like this, we need to all ask ourselves, well, why didn't we use public transportation? Why didn't it make sense? I saw a couple ladies this morning bringing in bottles of water and all that. How would have they packed that on a scat bus? That would have been difficult. So let's keep that in mind as we go throughout today. The theme of this year's workshop is growing healthy, resilient, and prosperous communities. You will hear both local and national speakers sharing best practices on local food, improved public health, economic opportunities, and addressing our vulnerabilities as a coastal community. I heard today in the news, and I think you may remember this, but I think it's actually today's the second anniversary of Hurricane Sandy. And if you remember what that did to that coastal community, which you normally don't, at least I didn't, someone who grew up in Florida, don't think of the Northeast as having a hurricane issue, okay? So they are still dealing with that. And Laird from our from Sarasota County is going to talk to you later about what we're trying to do in post-disaster type planning. It's not if, you know, it's when the hurricane hits us. How are we going to deal with it? How are we going to deal with it after it hits? And so we have some good plans that are being put in place right now to deal with that. You have an opportunity at the end of the workshop to come together and develop your own solutions. And our county commission truly values your input to identify priorities of future action. And that kind of goes back to what I was saying before. You know, when we meet, when you look at growth in Sarasota County, potential development, potential situations, whether it's inside the urban service boundary, outside the urban service boundary, how can we put your ideas effectively in place? And then the flip side of that is how can you efficiently in place? You know, we could have a bus running by here every 5 minutes and hopefully people would hop on it. But if they don't, then obviously your tax dollars are gonna, you know, your taxes will go up significantly. So that's the balance that we're always trying to work out. So your all's input to us, coming to us and say, hey, when you're making a policy decision, did you think about this? Can you add that? And so workshops like this are very helpful. From the perspective of Sarasota County government, we've seen the value of implementing sustainable practices for many years. In fact, earlier this year, we were honored to be chosen by the North American Host Committee for the World Environment Day. In just over 6 weeks, the partnering organizations hosted 55 events with 7,100 attendees. And I went to the event that was at Oscar Sheer State Park, and I can tell you that organization was very impressed with the proactive thinking that Sarasota County has done in trying to implement policies that you know, work for our community. Our residents have consistently shown us that sustainability is important to them through attendance at events like the World Environment Day. And your presence here today shows that too. In fact, the most recent annual citizen survey, 75% of the respondents said it's very important for county government to work on energy efficient consumption. So, as I walked in here today, and I was thinking through my mind how, you know, to ask you all the tough questions, I was glad to see, this is funny, this is a male thing, but the urinals in here are the non-water, non-flush urinals. And, you know, that's something that if you just think back 10 or 20 years ago and you go to any public restrooms, those, you just saw all the water that was being wasted. And so I know from our county government, when we are building buildings, it may be more expensive to do some things, but we are thinking about it. We just approved money to build four new fire stations, and the way those are being built, all these sustainability-type questions were asked and were being implemented in our new fire stations. Just this past fiscal year, Sarasota County educated 653 households on energy and water-saving strategies and provided energy kits that will help these households save over $91,000 per year. Today, you'll hear from Habitat for Humanity of South, what Habitat for Humanity of South Sarasota County is doing to help their clients reduce their energy costs dramatically. You also hear the importance of solid waste reduction strategies. Since a vote to adopt mandatory recycling in 1991, Sarasota County residents and businesses continue to embrace recycling. And when I travel throughout the state as a county commissioner and meet with other county governments, I'm still amazed that there are communities that don't do mandatory recycling. But it doesn't make a lot of sense, but there are. So maybe we can encourage them. In 2012, Sarasota County recognized that we're recognized for the highest traditional recycling rate. 47% of the total waste collected within the county was diverted from the landfill. And that's significant, just one, from the environment, but also as taxpayers in our community, the last thing we want to do is go around and build more landfills. The land's expensive, they smell bad, not as bad as they used to, but no one wants to live next to them. That property's taken off the tax rolls, and so the less landfills that we need is really significant when we plan for our future. With the momentum behind Eat Local Week this week, it's clear that local healthy food is also a priority. Sarasota County now has 8 community gardens, 46 school gardens, and a growing number of farmers markets, increasing the interest in gardening classes. I'm really going off topic here, but off the thing here, I really had an interesting conversation with a person that was running for Sarasota County Commission last night about agriculture and what we're going to do in the future if land continues or development continues out east of Sarasota County. And the debate was, what's the role of government in that? And how do we address incentivizing farmers to continue to farm versus government telling them, you must farm, you can't sell your land? How do we create policies that we can keep local growers here growing food that can be sold locally here and help them put off the pressures from their families that suddenly say, you know, we've been farming for 4 or 5 generations, it's time to sell. You know, we're tired of farming, we want to move on. And the discussion that we had is, how can government create incentives to do that through conservation easements, potentially buying the land ourselves? So how we keep farming here local, or agriculture here local, is a debate that we need to have as our community grows. Our county also leads our community by example, installing solar panels on the community operations center, and an extension of green building to cut down energy uses and costs. That's just another example of saying, as we are thinking about this, we are lucky enough to live in a community that our property values have gone up, and because of that, we've been able to have money and good fiscal management of your tax dollars, that we've been able to begin building the infrastructure that has been needed. New emergency operations center is just up the road here. You go through Bee Ridge and just on your right-hand side, and so talking about hurricane preparedness, we will now have an emergency operations center that, where it is right now, it's in the building, in the Ringling building, where our office is, you know, on the 6th floor. Hurricane 1 level winds, we have to move. So your emergency operations center has to go in emergency operation mode and move, okay? And we all saw what happened with Hurricane Charley. It's going to hit Tampa, and it's only a Hurricane 1, no big deal. Boom, it turns, becomes a hurricane level, you know, level 3, level 4, like that. So our folks can't think that. They have to think worst case scenario. So that is being solved right now, so that when the hurricane's going on, our folks have a safe place to work and be prepared that the moment it's over, they can get out and begin saving lives. Investing in fuel-saving technologies in our county fleet, including plug-in electric passenger cars and hybrid bucket trucks. Another spot. How many people came here in electric cars today? No? You got one. Well, two drove here today, and you've spoken to us several times about it. Hopefully, in the next 3 or 4 years, when we keep having these, that we get more and more folks. And we've talked about putting plug-in stations at our county buildings to help facilitate that. So energy efficiency and green building technology is a standard design criteria in the new county facilities, bringing taxpayer savings over the life of those facilities and healthier, more comfortable working environment for our employees and visiting public. You can see by these examples in the design of our new fire stations, emergency operations center, our new golf gate library, and many other facilities. So as we work together to reach a more sustainable community, workshops like these are important tools to meet and share information and discuss opportunities and move together toward common goals. We hope that through the expert speakers that you hear today, you'll discover new ways of improving sustainability and with your own home and with your business. So together, we can localize the economic impact and development and develop innovative ways to protect our environment and support improvements in health and for all members of our community. Now today, you know, how are we going to measure success of today? So this is the ninth one. So I think it's, what do we do with the information here? How does it get out to our community? So in 3 or 4 or 5 years, again, if someone asks you questions like I did today, there's a lot more hands, and that'll show that we've been a success. And I do want to let you know, from our county commission standpoint, you know, don't keep this information to yourself. Call us, set an appointment. Have us come to different meetings and say, hey, this is what we've learned. Here's what other communities are doing. How can we incorporate this here in Sarasota County? So sorry, Susan, I went a little longer, but I, you know, rather than just reading something to you, I did want you to know that this is something we think about all the time. So thank you.
Thank you.